It's me again. So today's story takes place in Green Bay, Wisconsin. So on the 23rd of February, I was a Wednesday 2022. A woman called the cops into her Green Bay home. So the cops got to the house. She called them because she had discovered her son's severed head in the bucket. So when she invited the cops to the house, they went to the basement and saw the son's head inside the bucket, wrapped in a blanket. So when they lifted the head, they saw his penis underneath the head in the bucket. So the woman said the last person her son was with was another, was a woman, a 24-year-old woman named Taylor Shabusiness. So how did they get here? So apparently on the 22nd of the month, which was on Tuesday, Taylor Shabusiness and her son, her late son now, nowadays his name is Shatiron. So he came into the house with his lover, who is Taylor Shabusiness. So when they got into the apartment, they were in the basement. According to the woman, she was with her boyfriend in the house, and then she went out with her boyfriend. So she thought they were just down in the basement the whole of that Tuesday. So not until 3 a.m. when she heard that the door outside was slammed shut. So she immediately came out. She thought Taylor Shabusiness was going out. So she decided to check up on her son, and then she found his head inside the bucket. So immediately the cops went out to search for Taylor Shabusiness, and then they found her in the east side. So when they found her, they saw some dried blood on her sweatpants, her hands, and all of that. And then the first question she asked them was, "Are you here because of my arrest warrants?" When they asked her, she said, "Yes, I guess you are here because of my arrest warrants." So they started questioning her, who was the last person in disguise, so what happened? And then she told them that, yes, actually that it was an accident, that she did not actually mean to kill him, but then they had smoked meth that day, the whole of that Tuesday, and they performed sexual activities. She said she just went crazy. According to her, she said while they were having sex that he was facing the bed, he was face down, and then there was a chain on his neck. So she put a chain on this guy's neck and she was choking him. She said in the process that she liked it, like in a very low tone of voice, you know, that kind of that. She liked it. And then while she was choking him, the guy was struggling for his life, and then, but she told herself that she has come this far, so she's not ready to like stop at this point in time. So she kept choking him, and then she questioned him. She told them, like, "Do you know what it means to love something so much to the point that you kill it? I mean, this woman, she needs to walk us through her thought process." Meanwhile, so they enjoy the story, and yeah, subscribe. So, back to our story. She told them that she did not actually mean to kill him. She said that along the time she was choking him, sometime in between she blacked out, and then when she woke up, she discovered that he was dead. She told them that it took her about 3 to 5 minutes to fully strangulate him, to strangle him to death. And then she knew that he was dead because his face had turned purple. She said after that, she performed lots of sexual activities on his dead body. Like, she performed lots of sexual activities for about 3 hours with his corpse. And then after that, she decided to dismember his body. She said she actually wanted to go to take all the parts of his corpse, all the parts of the corpse with them. She even told them casually that they were going to have lots of fun finding all the parts of the body because she actually dismembered it. She said she got very tired, and that was why she left the head and the penis in the bucket. She told them that I think there's a foot or a limb in the van. So when the cops entered her van, they saw his torso in a tote bag. Then they checked around, they saw a crock pot box. When they checked inside the box, they saw his limbs, some other parts of his organs, his internal organs. They found them inside a crock pot box that was inside her van. And then they saw her tote bag. When they checked inside, that was where they found his torso. She told them that his limbs are just scattered about, that she actually wanted to pack every piece of him because she loved him that much, so she wanted to pack every piece of him with her, but she just got lazy, and that was why she left the head there. She said apparently the investigator in charge of this case, when she got to the house, while they were reading her case, when she was arrested, currently she's in jail, she's awaiting trial.
He said she actually had a warrant out for her arrest before this particular incident. Not because of they didn't actually come there to arrest her because of the incident. It was because Taylor Shabizen was supposed to be on probation because she had been on probation. She's not supposed to go out without an electronic monitoring device on her. But so she went out without it for the whole of that 24 hours. That was why they were searching for her. That was why she had an arrest warrant against her. So apparently she had two criminal records already. She was charged for assaulting a police officer. She was charged for threatening another officer of the law. She was charged for attacking another person. So she had all of this. And then Taylor Shabizness happens to be a married woman with a kid. She had a child in 2020. So this woman is not your 24-year-old mate. Meanwhile, she said she's 24 years old. So she has a daughter. So she, after her crime, she was sentenced. She was given a probation. So she was supposed to be at home. Meanwhile, she went out to commit this other crime. But her husband, she's a married woman. Her husband happens to be in jail currently because of a very unrelated crime. He wasn't involved in any kind of murder case. So, Taylor Shabizness, as we speak now, she's currently on a $2 million bail in the jail. Meanwhile, the cops are trying to build up a case against her. So, she's facing three different charges: sexual assault in the first degree, the act she performed on Shatiron after murdering him. And then she's also facing first degree intentional homicide. And then she's facing third degree assault. So, she's facing this three counters, but she's currently on a $2 million bill as we speak. So that's it for me today on Taylor Shabizness. Thanks.